Hello children of class 6, how are you? Today I will teach you noun, gender, number and case. Here in box some words are there and we have to separate them in masculine or feminine. Which is feminine gender? Shepherd is masculine, monk masculine, stallion masculine, countess feminine, washerman masculine, niece feminine, governor masculine, tigress feminine, milkmaid feminine, peahen feminine, landlord masculine. Gender of a noun tells us whether a thing is masculine, feminine, common or neuter in gender. Masculine, which denotes a male, feminine, which denotes a female, and masculine, common, which denotes either a male or a female, and neuter denotes non-living thing, which is neither male nor female. Now let us see here example of common gender: student, person, baby, neighbor. Example of neuter gender: book, table, pen, etc. Now formation of feminine gender: we can change the masculine noun gender nouns or pronouns into feminine gender nouns or pronouns in the many ways. Some of these have been discussed here. Feminine gender: author, authoress; baron, baroness; tailor, tailoress; poet, poetess; heir, heiress; host, hostess; priest, priestess; shepherd, shepherdess; actor, actress; emperor, empress; god, goddess; governor, governess; prince, princess; waiter, waitress; master, mistress; tiger, tigress. Now by changing entire word: boar, sow; bachelor, spinster; buck, doe; bull, cow; cock, hen; colt, filly; gander, goose; drone, bee; father, mother; fox, vixen; drac, duck; husband, wife; monk, nun; hero, heroine; king, queen; lord, lady; stallion, mare; nephew, niece; sir, madam; son, daughter; wizard, witch; ram, ivy, sheep. Here we have seen from changing in whole word, it has been these words are changed from masculine to feminine. Now let us see by changing the masculine gender in a compound word: washerman, washerwoman; grandfather, grandmother; grandson, granddaughter; landlord, landlady; postmaster, postmistress; father-in-law, mother-in-law; brother-in-law, sister-in-law; son-in-law, daughter-in-law; stepfather, stepmother; stepson, stepdaughter. Now I will teach you singular nouns. Number of a noun tells us whether a noun is singular or plural. Singular or plural means one or many. Singular means one, plural means many, more than one. Singular means one and plural means more than one. When a noun refers to one person or thing, it is said to be singular. For example, ant, tree, table, cow, etc. When a noun refers to more than one person or thing, it is said to be plural. For example, ants, trees, tables, cows, etc. Now, formation of plural nouns. Generally, we form plurals by adding s to singular forms: dog, dogs; book, books; train, trains. Nouns of ending in ch, sh, s, double s or ox are formed in plural by adding es: branch, branches; box, boxes; mango, mangoes; dish, dishes; s, etc. Some nouns ending in o do not take es but s to form their plurals: piano, pianos; stereo, stereos; radio, radios; photo, photos, etc. If a singular noun ends in a vowel y, its plural is formed by simply adding s: boy, boys; donkey, donkeys; ray, rays; toy, toys, etc. If a singular noun ends in a consonant plus y, y changed into I before adding es: लिली लिलीज, डेरी डेरीज, फ्लाई फ्लाईज, सिटी सिटीज, फैमिली फैमिलीज, फेरी फेरीज. द नाउन एंडिंग ऑफ एफ और एफ ई फॉर्म देयर प्लूरल बाय चेंजिंग एफ और एफ ई इनटू वीईएस. नाइफ नाइव्स, काफ काव्स, हाफ हाफ्स, थीप थीप्स, लाइफ लाइव्स, वाइफ वाइव्स. सम नाउन्स एंडिंग इन एफ और एफ ई फॉर्म देयर प्लूरल बाय एडिंग एस एट द एंड. Hoof, hoofs, dwarfs, dwarfs, roof, roofs, proof, proofs, chief, chiefs, gulf, gulfs. Some nouns form their plural by completely changing the word. Child, children, ox, oxen, louse, lice, mouse, mice, criterion, criteria, phenomenon, phenomena. Here we see completely changing the word. Their number are changed. Some nouns form their plural by changing their inside vowels. Man, men, tooth, teeth, woman, woman, women, googe, geege, etc. Some nouns remain same in their singular and plural forms. Deer, deer, news, news, sheep, sheep, fruit, fruit, dozen, dozen, fish, fish. Compound nouns form their plurals by adding s to the main word. Sister-in-law, sisters-in-law, passer-by, passers-by, maid-servant, maid-servants, son-in-law, sons-in-law. Some nouns are always used in their plural form, such as scissors, trousers. Some nouns are singular in appearance but are plural, such as people, cattle, etc. Some nouns are plural in appearance but are singular, such as news, politics, etc. Now I will tell us about the position of a noun in a sentence and its grammatical function as a noun or a pronoun. Case of a noun tells us about the position of a noun, about the position of a noun in a sentence and its grammatical function as a noun or a pronoun. The position and the function of a noun or a pronoun in a sentence determines its case. We can say the position and the function, the state and the work of a noun or a pronoun in a sentence determines its case. There are three cases of noun. They are as follows: subjective or nominative case, objective or accusative case, possessive or genitive case. Subjective or nominative case: when a noun is used as the subject of a verb, when a noun is used as subject of a verb, it is said to be in the subjective or nominative case. Subject answers the question who. Example: Hari writes a letter. Hari is nominative case. Shreya is an intelligent girl. Shreya, nominative case. Objective or accusative case: when a noun is used at the object of a verb, it is said to be in the objective or accusative case. Object answers the question what or whom. Object answers the question what or whom. Soham eats a banana. Now banana is objective case. John reads the Bible. Bible is objective case because they are the object of a verb. The noun like banana or Bible is the object of a verb in the sentence. So they are objective case. Possessive or genitive case: we use an apostrophe with a noun, with or without s, to show possession. We use an apostrophe with s when a noun is singular. For example, the car of my father, my father's car. The pen of my teacher, the teacher's pen. The crops of farmer, the farmer's crops. In the above groups of words, father, teacher and farmer are singular nouns. We used an apostrophe with s to form their possessives. In singular nouns, apostrophe plus s is used to form their possessive, to show possession. Possession means belonging. We use an apostrophe with s when a plural noun does not end in s. For example, the park of children, the children's park. The meeting of men, the men's meeting. The hoofs of oxen, the oxen's hoofs. These are also taking apostrophe s because they are plural but do not end with s. In the above groups of words, children, men and oxen are plural nouns which do not end in s. We used an apostrophe with s to form their possessives. We use an apostrophe without s when a plural noun ends in s. When plural noun ends in s, then we use only apostrophe. The books of the students' books. Here students is a plural, so only apostrophe is used to show possession. Here boys is plural, so only apostrophe is used to show possession. Here foxes is plural, so only apostrophe is used to show possession. In the above groups of words, students, boys and foxes are plural nouns. We used only an apostrophe to form their possession. We do not use an apostrophe with non-living objects. The apostrophe is used in possessive case. Nominative or subjective case, when noun is the subject of a verb in the sentence. Objective or accusative case, when noun is the object of a verb in the sentence. And possessive or genitive case, when apostrophe is used to show possession or belonging. Today we have learned noun, gender, number and case. Thanks.